morning, student. Our next chapter is the structure of atom. In the first chapter, we study the basic concept of chemistry. All of you aware from the atom, what is atom? Daltonian theory. In the first chapter, we learn. Now, we see the atomic structure. A student, according to Dalton, we know that atom is indivisible, but as we become advanced and advanced in discovery or advancement in the science, it is discovered that atom is made up of some tiny particles. It become clear from the discovery of an electron. Electron discovered by the cathode rays. Okay. You have learned in 9th class also. This is the cathode rays discharge tube. Okay. Experiment. This is a glass tube. Here is cathode, here is anode, and this one is the vacuum pump, and here is air of very high pressure, and when high voltage is generated, then the gas is filled in this vacuum tube, become charged and start to the eliminate electron which goes from cathode to anode. Okay, here is very low pressure and very high voltage, which in the vacuum, whatever is gas will get ionized and released negative electron. Flow of current from cathode to anode further checked by the making hole of the anode. Okay, this way different types of things are placed here. Here is the zinc sulfide coating also, or it is also passed through the hose. Okay, flywheels are put here. What was the result of this? Result was this: first cathode ray start from the cathode, move toward the anode. This means it is made up of negative particles. These rays are not visible, okay, but their behavior could be observed by certain kind of material. Means when these ray pass on the fluorescent or the phosphorescent material, these rays become visible in the first form of fluorescence or phosphorescence. In the absence of electric or magnetic field, ray travel in a straight line. When electric field or magnetic field is applied above and below the glass tube, then diffraction takes place. In presence of electric or magnetic field, behavior of cathode ray are similar to expected from the negatively charged, as we were expecting from this point. Cathode rays start from the cathode towards, move towards the cathode to anode. It means something is negatively charged, which is due to which it is attracted toward the anode. Thus, this suggests that something is negatively charged, which is later on named electrons. Characteristic of cathode rays do not depend upon the material of electrode, but present gas present in it. It all depends upon the behavior of electron, or discovery of electron is not due to the cathode's material. It is due to the ionization of gas taken in the glass tube. Now charge to mass ratio of electron. The measurement of mass ratio of the electron charge to the mass electron by using the cathode ray discharge tube and the applying electrical and magnetic field perpendicular to each other. How can we measure this? By applying the magnetic and electric field perpendicular to the path of electron. Okay. Amount of deviation of particle, okay, from their path in the presence of electric and magnetic field depends upon, means to say that how much deviation from the straight path of cathode ray takes place, it depends on following three points. One, if the magnitude of negative charge on the particle greater the magnitude of charge on the particles, greater is the interaction with the electric and magnetic field. If meant to say that if interaction is more toward the electric or magnetic field, deviation will be more. It means magnitude of charge will be very high. Next, mass of particle is lighter particle, greater if deflection is very very high, it means particle is very light. Okay. Strength of electric and magnetic field, the deflection of electrons from the original path increases with increasing voltage. As well as we increase the voltage, strength of electric field, magnetic field increases and deflection also increases. It means deflection is directly proportional to the strength of magnetic field and electric field. Okay. This way we can say the amount of deviation of particle from its path in presence of electric and magnetic field depend on three points. One is the interaction with the electric and magnetic field. Second, mass of particle, and third is the strength of electric and magnetic field. These are the three major factors which help in measuring the electron by mass value of any charged particle. Here we are taking the example of electron. Okay. Now, when only electric field is applied, suppose we are applying either electric field or magnetic field. When only electric field applied, electron deviate from path, hit the cathode ray tube at point A, means where is positive charge, electron deflect towards that, or cathode ray deflects toward. It means, as we know, electron is negatively charged, it will move toward the positive point. Okay. When only magnetic field is applied, similar condition is here, but it moves toward the magnetic fields, as you will learn in the magnetism, deflection of electron in magnetic field. When electron deviate from their path, then both electrical and magnetical field is applied. It is possible to bring them back and electron go and hit the screen at point B. Okay. Thus, this conclusion we get the electron mass ratio, which is 1.76882 0 into 10 to power 20 10^11 कूलाम पर केजी। ओके, दिस वे वी कंक्लूडेड दैट द एलिमेंट्री पार्टिकल विच इज द एलिमेंट्री पार्टिकल विच इज eliminated from the cathode was nothing but electrons, and electrons are negatively charged, and their electron by mass ratio is 1.7588 to 0 into 10.11 coulomb per kg. Okay, this way in this video we learn how the electrons are discovered in chapter structure of atom. In next chapter we will study the discovery of proton and neutron. Good day, students.